There is a lot to talk about today. Police have identified the gunman who showed up at the Houston airport shooting Thursday afternoon. It left the shooter dead and the terminal on lockdown. Stu's flight was canceled yesterday, and it was difficult to get in here. I'm sorry, but I find it a little hard to believe that somehow or another the NRA convention was happening here, and somebody would come into town from out of town, grab a hotel room, and then decide to kill themselves in the airport after firing an AK or an AR-15. I find it really difficult to believe that those two things are unconnected.
Amazing coincidence, at least
at Bush Airport as well.
At Bush Airport. I mean, wow, that's what are the odds on that one? Somebody call Vegas. Thursday, the Blaze had learned from sources that the person intended to, quote, take out the entire terminal. That was confirmed later by KHOU-TV Thursday night, which reported that the man, 29-year-old Carnell Moore of Beaumont, had left a suicide note that said that he had a bigger plan but decided to show mercy on others. That note said that he had a monster within and wanted to, police to take care of it. From the report, Moore posted two cryptic messages on his Facebook wall Wednesday. This life will crash tomorrow, and I recently had the chance of staring death in the face, and she was beautiful. Okay, let me just... this is the story from The Blaze, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, we should call the author of this story and just make sure that... they understand that those weren't necessarily cryptic messages.
I think that may be an AP story, actually.
Really?
That's posted on The Blaze.
Well, that makes more sense because I'm trying to figure out who did I hire that thought this life will crash tomorrow, and I just had the chance of staring death in the face, and she was beautiful.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think
cryptic.
The hiring process has gotten a little slippery here.
Yeah, that is from the report.
Okay.
Although, I mean, he's not. This life will crash tomorrow. If someone posted that on the Facebook page, you would immediately arrest them?
No, no, no. This life will crash tomorrow. Well, if I have a friend who is on Facebook, I mean, an actual friend on Facebook, and I see them write this life will crash tomorrow, I call them. And say, hey, dude, what's happening? What's going on? If I have a friend who says, this life will crash tomorrow, and I recently had the chance of staring death in the face and she was beautiful, I might drive over to their house.
It wasn't. It's like,
hey, dude, what's happening? What do you say? You and I go to the hospital. How are you feeling?
Yeah.
So he had been staying in a Houston hotel for the last few days. He would have turned 30 this month. Citing Houston Police Department, the law enforcement officer that fired Moore was Homeland Security Special Agent that fired at the gunman at the same time that Moore shot himself in the head. Yesterday, we talked about this, and I thought there were a couple of things. That one, somebody wanted to go out in a blaze of glory, and then realized that's not who I am, you know, I can't kill others. I might want to kill myself, but I can't kill others. And just shot the AR and then shot himself. The part of this that bothers me is the AR and the NRA. I'm sorry, it's George Bush International Airport, the week of the NRA, and it's an AR. And he only shot it a couple of times in the air, and then he put it down on the ground and pulled out his revolver to shoot himself. So why did you bring the AR?
Yeah, I mean, you think maybe he was trying to make a point that he could have done something worse or something to that effect?
I don't know. There is a part of me that says this is as a journalist and somebody that runs a journalistic organization. I told Scott Baker within minutes of this happening, I said, "Here's what I want you to look for. I want you to look for those. I want you to look for the gun. Tell me everything you can about the gun." Was it a stolen gun? If it's a stolen gun, that really tells me something new and something really, really important that makes me think more that it's a setup for the NRA. I want to find out if this guy has been unemployed, if he was a union worker, if he's ever attended any Occupy Wall Street stuff. Has he ever been, like, for instance, those guys who did the Saudi, the guys who went to the Saudi mosque and then pulled off the Boston massacre. What happened? they were radicalized at the mosque and then kicked out of the mosque. And that's when, I believe, a handler followed them out of the mosque and said, "Hey, dude, you're making a lot of sense to me. How can I help you?" And that's what I think needs to be looked at in this particular case. Has this guy ever gone to an Occupy Wall Street thing? Has he ever been around a bunch of revolutionaries? If he has been, when somebody loses a job or somebody says, "Hey, I've seen the angel of death lately and she's beautiful," that's the kind of person that is somebody who is on the Uber left targets and says, "Hey, dude, I understand, man. That's crazy, isn't it? You should do something important. You know what you should do? Man, we could get those guys. You know what you do is you take this AR-15, you go to the airport during the NRA, and you just shoot everybody. Wouldn't that be great?" And the guy is so screwed up in his head that he goes to the airport in this particular case. And I'm not saying that this has happened. I'm saying you should look into it as a journalistic organization. Find out about the gun. Find out if you've ever been connected any way to any of those kinds of organizations and take it from there.
Yeah, because unlike a lot of the reporting we've been doing lately on The Blaze, this is you theorizing. This is you thinking this could be something that, you know, something to look for.
Put all the options on the table. Is anybody else think that it is... I mean, it could happen. It really could happen. It could have been just a lone gunman, had no idea anything else was going on. But really, there's some abnormal things that pop up here that maybe we should look at. It's a coincidence that the first day of the convention at George Bush Airport, during these times, a guy takes an AK-47. When's the last time that happened?
An AR-15.
Or AR-15. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, when's the last time that happened?
There was one in Los Angeles years and years and years ago, right? At the LA airport, LAX, I think.
Right.
I mean, but it's been a long time.
Right. And it just seems he's from Beaumont. There's a few airports around here and there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He comes to this one in Houston this week, yesterday.
Yeah, it was certainly my first thought,
right,
to be perfectly
honest.
It's
worth looking into. I'm not saying that's what happened, but it's worth looking into. And I only jumped to that conclusion that it needs to be looked into because I have been, I've studied revolutions, and this happens all the time in the beginning of revolutions. In Germany, it was the Reichstag fire. And something happens, everybody goes into a panic, and then laws are passed, and all of a sudden it's lights out.
Yeah.
Somebody should look into it, we are.
Yeah, it's worth, obviously, looking into any possibility when you have a guy going in and potentially shooting people at an airport.
It is equally as possible this guy was just totally crazy, totally depressed, went up and decided, you know what, I'm going to do the merciful thing, but I'm just going to go, I want my name in the press. But I think that any way that happens, this guy got there and realized, or he got up in the morning and realized, I'm not that guy. I'm not the guy to go kill a bunch of people. There was still some bit of Americanism in him, I think.
But he still wanted to be taken out by a police officer, apparently.
Right.
Because he mentions that in the notes. So, maybe that figures into it too. Maybe that was just an easy place to be shot by a police officer.
This was the first thing that I said when my security detail came over to me and said, "Sir, there's been a shooting at the airport, blah, blah, blah." Scott Baker comes running in and he says, "There's a shooting." And I said, "Tell me what you know." And they said he shot two bullets into the air with an AR-15. Then he dropped the gun as he saw somebody approach, and he shot himself. And I said, the only reason why this one doesn't quite make sense is because he did indeed shoot himself. But what that sounded like to me, and I said immediately, I said, this sounds like a guy who wanted to die, shot him up in the air because he could do death by cop. But what didn't work on that piece of the scenario is, why did he shoot himself? If you're too much of a coward to do it, you go to the airport and you shoot up in the air and you have a gun and you're wielding it and you've already demonstrated that you'll shoot and you'll be shot. Now, why did you then shoot yourself? That's the only thing. If you're saying in your suicide note, I'm going to have the cops help me with that. Mm-hmm. Well, you didn't. You could have done that in your hotel room.
I don't know. They say that the shot from himself and the cop or
came
the Homeland Security came at about the same time. But maybe the guy missed him and then he shot because he thought This guy's not going to get me.
No, they have to do an autopsy to figure out which one which one killed him.
Yeah, I've heard that. I've heard that. But he may have gotten afraid that he'd just be wounded. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe.
Which
I don't know.
Which one do you root for if you're the officer that shot? Do you root for that you took him out, or do you root for that he took himself out?
He took himself out.
Yeah. I don't know, because you did something really positive.
No, I don't think anybody, I don't think any police officer, I mean, we've got three of them sitting over here. Just let me know if you guys can hear me. I don't think any police officer wants to be responsible for shooting even the worst guy. I don't think you want to be responsible for killing him. Shooting him, taking him down, but not killing him, right? Yeah, they're all shaking their head. No man.
This is why I'm not a cop. I mean, I never said I had qualifications.
I mean, quite honestly, I think we should have HR stop by and just talk to you. Have you seen the Angel of Death lately? And is she beautiful?
All I know,
it's a little curious. No, it's a little curious that, I mean, you would think that.
Because I'm just saying it's something to be proud of.
No, it's something
to be proud of. If you took out a guy with a gun.
Killing another man.
Absolutely. In this situation, absolutely.
The guy is going to kill somebody.
Absolutely.
But he hadn't.
No.
For instance, if I go
roll around. You're just shooting into the air, sir? Okay, you're fine. Just go ahead. Just keep shooting it straight up. Don't aim it too low, though.